Ladies and gentlemen, very good evening to you.
Dame i gospodo, dobroveče svima.
It is wonderful to see your face and it is wonderful to acknowledge that we have had a good day.
Predivno je vidjeti vaša lica i predivno je podsjetiti se toga da smo imali jedan predivan dan.
You know, the title of this presentation, I try to read it in Serbian.
Pokušat ću da pročitam naslov ovog predavanja na srpskom.
Sutra počinje danas. So, basically, tomorrow starts today.
Dakle, sutra počinje danas.
What does this mean?
Šta znači ova izjava?
We have been on a journey during this week.
Ove sedmice bili smo na jednom putovanju.
We have seen that when we come into the reality of God.
Vidjeli smo da kad dođemo u Božji domen, Božju realnost,
God is giving us strength to live a decent life on this earth.
Bog nam daje snagu da živimo jednim primjernim dobrim životom na ovoj zemlji.
But the question is life only what we live here and that's it?
Ali pitanje koje se postavlja jeste, da li je život sve ovo što ovdje vidimo i doživimo na zemlji?
Or is there something more than the life lived here on this earth?
Ili postoji nešto više od života koje provedemo ovdje na ovoj zemlji?
You know, when we think about how Jesus came on this earth.
Kada razmišljamo o tome kako je Isus došao na ovaj svijet.
He was born here and there was no place for him in Bethlehem.
On je rođen na ovom svijetu i nije bilo mjesta u Vitlemu za njega.
And he did not get upset and went back to heaven immediately.
I on se nije odlučio na povratak momentalno na nebo.
He stayed and he introduced how we should live on this earth.
Već je ostao i dao nam je primjer kako se to treba živjeti na ovoj zemlji.
He also introduced the principles of his kingdom on earth.
Također nam je prikazao principe njegovog carstva na zemlji.
Then we have seen he suffered and died.
Mogli smo da vidimo kako je umro i kako je stradao prije toga.
But we thank God that he rose again and he is alive.
Ali hvala Bogu da je on vaskrsno i da je živ.
And we serve a living Jesus Christ.
I mi služimo jednog živog Isusa Hrista.
But wouldn't you like to see him face to face?
Zar ne bi volio da ga sretnete jednog dana oči u oči?
Wouldn't you like to read something from his word that actually he is planning to come back to see us and to take us into his kingdom.
Zar ne biste volili da pročitate određene tekstove iz Biblije, iz ove knjige, koje govore o tome kako on želi da se vrati na ovaj svijet i da nas povede u svoje carstvo.
So that kind of tomorrow starts today.
Kad je reč o činjenici da sutra počinje danas,
because it is very possible that in the future, in the near future, we can see Jesus Christ.
Poenta jeste da sutra, znači u bliskoj budućnosti, možemo očekivati taj dan kada će Isus Hristos da se vrati i imat ćemo priliku da ga ugledamo.
As a pastor, I officiated many weddings.
Kao svešteno lice, vodio sam mnoga venčanja već do sada.
And it is always very nice to see how the groom is behaving, waiting for the bride.
I uvijek je posebno divni moment kada izađe mladoženja i čeka da se pojavi mlada.
Imagine a hall like this.
Zamislite jednu salu poput ove.
The groom comes in.
Mladoženja je ušao.
And everybody is waiting and looking towards the door.
I svi čekaju moment, poseban moment i gledaju ka vratima.
And for some reason the bride is late a little bit.
I zbog nekog razloga mlada kasni malo.
And I have seen worry on the face of the groom saying, is she coming at all?
I u takvoj jednoj situaciji imao sam prilike da vidim jednu malu zabrinutost na licu mladoženje. Da će nešto tu da se iskomplikuje, da će se uopšte pojaviti.
Every second spent in waiting.
Svaki moment koji se provede u čekanju
felt like eternity to him.
Mu se čini kao da je čitava večnost.
And suddenly we could hear the sound of music.
I odjednom čuje se muzika.
The door opened.
Vrata se otvaraju.
And this beautiful bride came in.
Predivna nevesta je ušla.
Then I looked at the face of the groom.
Tada sam pogledao mladoženju.
That smile
taj
communicated.
Osmeh je komunicirao, dao do znanja.
It was worth waiting.
Da je vredelo čekati.
He has never seen a beautiful creature like that, like his bride in all his life.
Nikad u životu nije video tako predivno biće, stvoreno biće kao što je njegova mlada.
You know, if I were to summarize this book, the Bible.
Znate, kad bi ja trebao da rezimiram suštinu ove knjige Biblije,
I would tell this.
Ja bih kazao sljedeće.
The first 39 books of the Bible.
Prvih 39 knjiga Biblije.
From Genesis until Malachi.
Od prve knjige Mojsijeve do Malahije.
Could sum up with the message the Messiah is coming.
Mogu da se rezimiraju iščekivanjem dolaska Mesije.
Jesus is coming.
Isus dolazi.
And then you move into the New Testament of the Bible.
I tada kad pređete na novozavetni deo Biblije.
And four books, the four writings of the Gospels.
Na početku imate četiri knjige, četiri evanđelja.
Talk about the message that Jesus has come.
I ova evanđelja nam iznose poruku da je Isus došao.
And in his name Emmanuel, God is with us.
I u suštini njegovo ime Emanuilo znači da je Bog sa nama.
And then the remaining books of the New Testament, 23 books.
A u ostali 23 novozavetnih spisa,
are having the message to us that Jesus is coming back.
Odzvanja jedna ključna poruka, a to ta poruka jeste da se Isus vraća po nas.
And Jesus talks about this in a promise, probably the most beautiful promise in the whole Bible.
I Isus govori o ovom događaju kao obećanju. Posebno lepo je ovo obećanje formulisano u jednom od najlepših delova Svetog pisma.
This is written in John chapter 14 and I'm asking Laslo.
Riječ je o Jovanu 14. glavi i čitaćemo tekst. Da se ne plaši srce vaše. Verujte Boga i mene verujte. Mnogi su stanovi u kući oca mojega, a da nije tako, kazao bih vam. Idem da vam pripravim mesto. I kad otidem i pripravim vam mesto, opet ću doći i uzet ću vas sebi da i vi budete gde sam ja. Reče mu Toma, gospode, ne znamo kuda ideš i kako možemo poznati? Isus mu reče, ja sam put i istina i život, niko neće doći k ocu do kroz me.
Jesus talks to us.
Isus nam progovara.
And this brings a lot of hope into our hearts.
I upravo taj njegov govor daje puno nade našem srcu.
And he says it is good to trust God, it is good to believe in God and it is good to trust him and believe in him
Isus
too.
Isus kaže dobro je vjerovati Bogu, dobro je imati povjerenja njemu i ono što on govori.
His message is coming to us saying trust in my presence.
Njegova poruka jeste imajte povjerenje kad je riječ o mom prisustvu.
Do not let your hearts be troubled.
Da se ne plaši srce vaše.
Has your heart been troubled at all in your life?
Da li se ikad u vašem životu vaše srce uznemirilo?
You know, when your kids are going for a very long trip, are you troubled? Do you feel a kind of a trepidation inside?
Kada vaša deca krenu neki dugačak put, da li postoji neki nemir u vašoj duši, u vašem srcu? Da li razmišljate o tome šta se događa sa njima?
Jesus says, trust my presence.
Isus je kazao, imajte povjerenje u moje prisustvo.
What does trust mean?
Šta podrazumeva povjerenje?
Let's see what the Webster's dictionary says.
Pogledajmo šta kaže Websterov rečnik. Povjerenje podrazumeva oslanjanje na nekoga ili nešto. Reč je o veri da će se nešto dogoditi, da će neko da deluje u skladu sa onim što je propisano.
Trust is a basic dependence on someone.
Dakle, poverenje podrazumeva da zavisite od nekoga.
It's like saying to Jesus, Jesus, I depend 100% on you.
Kao da želite da kažete Isuse, Isuse, ja se oslanjam 100% na tebe.
Without you, I can't do nothing.
Bez tebe ništa ne mogu učiniti.
I need you every single moment of my life.
Potreban si u svakom momentu mog života.
And I want to trust you.
I želim da imam povjerenje u tebe.
Jesus looks at his disciples and he says,
Isus je pogledao svoje učenike i kazao
je, I know that you trust in God.
Znam da vi verujete Bogu.
I also know you trust in me too.
Znam da imate i u mene poverenje.
Now remember this.
A sada se setite
ovoga. There is going to be a time when you are not going to see me.
Doći će vreme kad me više nećete moći videti.
And I'm asking you to trust me even then.
I ja vas molim da kad dođu ti momenti, tada imate poverenje.
So when Jesus is not seen by our physical eyes,
dakle kad nismo u stanju da svojim fizičkim očima vidimo Isusa,
he is experienced through our heart that he is present.
U tim momentima svojim srcem ćemo doživjeti njegovo prisustvo, imat ćemo poverenje u njegovo prisustvo.
And I am so glad that he left with us his word, the Bible.
I toliko mi je drago da imamo u svojoj ruci njegovu reč,
my Bibliju. Friend,
prijatelji moji,
when you read the Bible,
kada čitate Bibliju,
feel and experience that Jesus is sitting next to you.
Onda u suštini imate mogućnost da iskusite šta to znači da Isus sa vama kao da sedi pored vas.
Hey, do not worry.
Kao da vam kaže, nemoj da se brineš.
Trust in God.
Veruj u Boga.
Trust also in me.
Veruj u mene.
The journey what you are taking,
put na koji polaziš,
is happening under my guidance.
Događa se, odvija se pod mojim vodstvom.
And I'm giving you my word.
I ja ti dajem moju reč,
which serves like a map as you journey.
Koja funkcioniše poput mape kad si na putu.
There is a story about Dr. Einstein.
Postoji jedna priča vezana za doktora Einsteina.
He was traveling on a train and he was heading towards an appointment.
Putovao je vozom i išao je na sastanak.
And the ticket collector came.
Došao je kondukter.
Checking the tickets of the passengers.
Provjeravao je karte putnika.
And when he got to the seat where Dr. Einstein was sitting.
I kad je došao na mjesto gdje je sjedio Dr. Einstein,
the ticket collector almost died of a heart attack.
Kondukter je skoro umro od srčanog udara.
He said, wow, this is the best day of my
life. Kaže, wow, pa to je najlepši dan moga života.
Dr. Einstein on my train.
Dr. Einstein na mom vozu.
This is such a wonderful thing.
To je tako predivna stvar.
Fantastic.
Fantastično.
To see that the great scientist.
Fantastično je vidjeti velikog naučnika.
He's searching all his pockets and he's
searching
for his ticket. Taj naučnik
je pretraživao svoje džepove i tražio svoju kartu.
And the ticket collector says,
a kondukter je kazao, gospodine,
calm down.
Nema problema.
As far as I am the conductor on this train.
Dok sam ja kondukter na ovom vozu.
You travel as far as you want.
Vi idete dokle god želite.
You are the greatest scientist of our century.
Vi ste najveći naučnik našeg veka.
It is an honor and a pleasure to be the conductor of this train when you are sitting.
Velika je čast biti kondukter na vozu na kojem se vi vozite.
I don't need your ticket.
Ne treba mi vaša karta.
It's a pleasure having you, sir.
Prosto je zadovoljstvo imati vas na vozu.
And the ticket collector moved on.
I kondukter je nastavio.
Checked out the tickets.
I provjeravao je vozne karte drugi putnika.
And just before he left that car of the train.
I prije nego što je napustio taj vagon,
he looked back from the door.
Ponovo je bacio svoj pogled nazad.
Said, what a wonderful day.
I kazao je ponovo, kako je ovaj fantastičan dan. Einsteina sam imao na svom vozu.
But suddenly he couldn't see the head of the scientist.
I odjednom dok je posmatrao putnike, nije mogao da vidi glavu naučnika.
And the conductor went back to check whether is he okay.
I kondukter se vratio na mjesto i vidi da li je sve u redu sa njim.
To find the scientist on his elbows and knees searching under the seat for his ticket.
I kad je došao na njegovo mjesto, naučnik Einstein, jel tako, je bio na svojim kolenima i pretraživao je sedište i ispod sedišta tražio je svoju voznu kartu.
So then the conductor tapped him on the shoulder,
i onda kondukter ga je malo tapkao po ramenima.
Dr. Einstein.
Kaže, pa doktore Einstein.
Don't look for that ticket.
Nemojte tražiti tu voznu kartu.
I know you are an honest man.
Znam da ste vi pošten čovjek.
I know you bought your ticket.
Znam da ste vi kupili vašu kartu.
Sit down, please.
Sedite, molim vas.
Travel easy.
Opustite se na putu.
I know who you are.
Znam ja ko ste vi.
Einstein looked up to him and said.
Einstein je pogledao i kazao je.
I know who I am too.
Pa ja znam ko sam ja.
But I don't know what is my destination. That's why I need that.
Ali ne znam kuda idem i zato mi treba karta.
You see?
Da li vidite?
We need to know our destination.
Trebamo znati gdje smo se to uputili.
When we are taking a journey,
kada smo pošli na put,
we need to check on the map that this is where we are traveling to.
Onda je potrebno da na mapi tačno lociramo mjesto kuda putujemo.
Even the navigation systems are working on the basis of maps.
Čak i GPS sistemi rade na osnovu mapa.
If you don't know your destination, you are going to wander around all your life.
Ako ne znate svoj krajnji cilj, krajnju destinaciju, čitavog života ćete lutati.
So Jesus says, trust my presence.
I Isus je kazao, imajte povjerenje u moje prisustvo.
Believe my word.
Vjerujte moje riječi.
And know your destination.
I budite svjesni destinacije koju ste se uputili.
But you know, it's easy to say trust.
Ali lako je kazati, veruj.
But we all have a little bit of Thomas in us.
Ali svi imamo delić Tome u nama.
Thomas was the disciple of Jesus who doubted almost all the time.
Toma je bio Isusov učenik koji je vrlo često imao sumnje.
And he didn't want actually to believe that actually Jesus was resurrected.
Kad je Isus vaskrsnuo, nije htio da povjeruje tu činjenicu.
But before we go to see Thomas how he doubted,
ali prije nego što proučimo njegov slučaj
kako
je sumnjao,
I would like to give an example how we can trust Jesus and we can take him on his word.
Želio bih da vam dam jedan primjer kako možemo da imamo povjerenje Isusa Hrista i kako možemo da ga uzmemo za riječ.
In the Gospel of John chapter 4.
U Evanđelju po Jovanu u 4. glavi.
There is a story about the king's official.
Zapisana je jedna priča, jedan istiniti događaj o carskom službeniku.
His son was sick.
Njegov sin je bio bolestan.
This king's official heard about Jesus.
Ovaj službenik cara čuje za Isusa.
He trusted, he believed that Jesus would help.
I on je vjerovao, imao je povjerenje da Isus može da pomogne.
He jumps on his horse.
Seo je na svoj konj.
And he's riding his horse 3.5 hours until he gets to Cana.
I krenuo je na put do Kane koji traje otprilike 3.5 sati.
And goes to see Jesus and says.
I otišao je da se sretne sa Isusom i kazao je.
Sir, please come before my child dies.
Gospode, siđi dok nije umrlo dete moje.
There are many people who are looking for a miracle from Jesus.
Postoje mnogi ljudi koji bi žele da vide neko čudo da Isus učini.
Jesus doesn't want to perform any miracles only to satisfy our curiosity.
Isus nikada ne želi da učini čudo samo da bi zadovoljio ljudsku znatiželju.
Jesus looks at this man and says.
Ali Isus je pogledao ovog čovjeka i kazao je,
I don't need to go into your house.
Ne trebam da idem u tvoj dom.
You may go.
Ti možeš da pođeš.
You have my word.
Imaš moju reč.
Your son lives.
Tvoj sin će živjeti.
And the Bible says.
I Biblija kaže.
This man took Jesus on his word.
Ovaj čovjek je prosto uzeo Isusa za reč, imao je povjerenje u njegovu reč.
And departed.
I otišao je.
If I were that father,
da sam ja bio taj otac,
I would have jumped on my horse.
Ja bi skočio.
3.5 hours back to
Kapernaum. Ponovo bi jahao 3.5 sata do Kapernauma.
And I would rush into the room of my son.
Utrčao bi u sobu mog sina.
And see whether he was alive.
I pogledao bi da li je on zaista živ.
But the Bible says that this man took Jesus at his word.
Ali Biblija kaže da je ovaj čovjek povjerovao Isusu.
He stayed overnight in Cana.
Ostao je, prenoćio je u Kani.
He goes back next day.
Sljedećeg dana se vraća kući.
When the servant saw this man coming,
kada je sluga video kako dolazi ovaj čovjek,
run to see him.
I potrčao je da ga vidi.
He said, your son is well, your son is okay.
I kazao je ovom čovjeku, tvoj sin je zdrav, on je živ.
If I were that father,
da sam ja taj otac,
I would have asked, where is my son?
Ja bi postavio pitanje, gdje je moj sin?
But he's not asking where is my son.
Ali on ne postavlja pitanje, gdje je sin?
He's asking when did it happen.
Već postavlja pitanje, kada se to dogodilo?
And they say, in the seventh hour of the day yesterday.
I oni kažu, u 7. času jučerašnjeg dana.
And the man remembered that was exactly, that's actually 1 o'clock in the afternoon.
A čovjek se sjetio, to je po našem računju vremena 1 sat popodne, tačno se sjetio da je to sat.
When Jesus told him, go, your son lives.
Kada je Isus rekao, idi, tvoj sin je živ.
The word of Jesus is as good as his presence.
Isusova reč je jednako dobra kao i njegovo prisustvo.
When we open the Bible, Jesus talks to us.
Kada otvorimo Bibliju, Isus nam progovara
and
kroz nju.
And we feel him sitting next to us.
I osjećamo kao da on sedi pored nas.
But Thomas, He doubted all the time.
Ali Toma je sumnjao sve vrijeme.
He didn't want to believe that Jesus rose again.
On nije htio da povjeruje da je Isus vaskrsnuo.
So we have a little bit of Thomas in us.
Tako da svi imamo u sebi neku dozu Tome.
Let's read what happened when Jesus rose.
Čitajmo šta se dogodilo kad je Isus vaskrsnuo. A drugi mu učenici govorahu, vide smo Gospoda. A on im reče, dok ne vidim na rukama njegovim rana od klina i ne metnem prsta svojega u rane od klina i ne metnem ruke svoje u rebra njegova, neću verovati.
Good guy.
Dobar čovjek.
Thomas says.
Toma kaže.
I am totally fine as a disciple of Jesus.
Ja sam potpuno dobar učenik Isusa.
I am a nice man.
Ja sam dobar čovjek.
I have a problem with this finger.
Ali imam problem samo sa jednim svojim prstom.
This finger cannot believe that Jesus rose again.
Samo ovaj moj prst ne može da vjeruje da je Isus vaskrsnuo.
Many of us we find some excuses why we don't believe.
Mnogi od nas tražimo izgovore zašto ne vjerujemo.
And Thomas says, unless I can touch his wounds, I can't believe.
I Toma kaže, dok nemam priliku da dodirne njegove rane, neću povjerovati.
Because somehow belief comes through my finger.
Jer nekako vera dolazi kroz moj prst.
And Jesus listens to Thomas' request.
I Isus je poslušao molbu Tome.
8 days later, Jesus comes again and visits the disciples.
Nakon 8 dana, Isus ponovo dolazi da posjeti svoje učenike.
And when Jesus comes in,
i kada je Isus ušao,
Thomas is there.
Toma je prisutan.
And the Bible says that although the doors were closed,
i Biblija je zabeležila da iako su vrata bila zatvorena,
Jesus comes in.
Isus je i pored toga ušao.
And he says, peace be with you.
I kazao je, mir vam.
Then he turns to Thomas directly.
I onda se direktno obraća Tomi.
And he says, Thomas,
i kaže, Tomo,
now take your unbelieving finger to me.
Uzmi svoj neverni prst.
Put your finger into my wound.
Stavi svoj prst u moje rane, moju ranu.
And come and touch me.
I dođi da me dodirneš.
And believe.
I veruj.
Imagine Thomas.
Zamislite samo Tomu.
He is red on his face all over.
Bio je crven do ušiju.
He takes his finger,
uzima svoj prst,
and he brings it to Jesus.
I prilazi sa prstom Isusu.
And a miracle is happening.
I čudo se događa.
When he is touching Jesus,
kada dodiruje Isusa,
it is not only his finger who believes,
ne samo da njegov prst počinje da veruje,
but also his knees.
Već i njegova kolena.
He kneels down and he says, my Lord, my God.
On je kleknuo i kazao je, Gospode moj i Bože moj.
Trust the presence of Jesus.
Verujmo u Hristovo prisustvo.
And then Jesus moves on and says, after you trust my presence,
i Isus je u svom govoru nastavio i kazao je, nakon što ste poverovali u moje prisustvo,
trust my actions.
Verujte i mojim delima.
In my father's house there are many rooms.
Mnogi su stanovi u kući oca mojega.
If it were not so, Jesus would have told us.
A da nije tako, Isus bi nam to kazao.
I am going to prepare a place for you. This is what Jesus says.
Evo šta kaže Isus, idem da vam pripravim mesto.
In order to understand what is Jesus doing
kako
here,
kako bi razumeli šta Isus radi u ovoj situaciji,
how he is using two big images,
trebamo biti svesni da koristi dve velike slike.
One is the picture of the journey and the other one is the picture of wedding.
Jedna je slika putovanja, a druga je slika svadbe.
This is how we understand the actions of Jesus.
I upravo iz ove pozadine prilazeći možemo razumjeti ono što Isus čini.
In Jesus' times when they were traveling,
u Isusovo vrijeme kad su ljudi putovali,
they sent part of the companion in advance that they would prepare the lodging and food for the rest of the group.
Onda su poslali jednu grupicu od putnika naprijed i oni su pripremili oni su se postavili za smještaj i za hranu.
Many times when Jesus traveled, some of the disciples went forth and they prepared everything.
Često kad je Isus putovao, onda je poslao nekoliko učenika unaprijed da pripreme teren.
By the time Jesus arrived,
dok je Isus došao na određeno mjesto, stolovi su postavljeni,
everything was ready.
Sve je bilo spremno.
So they were to prepare the way that Jesus would come.
Dakle, oni su trebali da pripreme put kako bi Isus mogao doći.
The disciples of Jesus of today.
Učenici Isusa koji žive danas.
They need to do the same.
Oni imaju isti zadatak.
Until Jesus is preparing a place for us in his kingdom,
dok nam Isus pripravlja mesto u svome carstvu,
we are preparing a place for Jesus in our heart.
Mi pripremamo mesto Hristu u našem srcu.
And also we help people in our surrounding to get ready to accept Jesus.
Također pomažemo ljudima u našem okruženju da prihvate Isusa.
We prepare a place for Jesus in our children's hearts.
Pripravljamo mesto Isusu u srcima naše dece.
In the hearts of our family members.
U srcima članova naše porodice.
In the hearts of our friends.
U srcima naših prijatelja.
And all our acquaintances.
I u srcima svih naših poznanika.
Jesus talks about his home.
Isus ovdje govori o svom domu.
And the Bible is using all sorts of expressions to illustrate God's kingdom.
I Biblija koristi više izraza kako bi ukazao na razne aspekte Božjeg carstva.
Sometimes this book uses a country.
Uses what?
A country.
U ovoj knjizi neka se spominje carstvo.
Indicating the vastness of that kingdom.
I ova slika ukazuje na prostranstvo Božjeg carstva.
Sometimes it is using the expression of city.
Ponekad se koristi izraz grad.
Putting more emphasis on the number of inhabitants.
I kroz ovu sliku naglašava se veliki broj stanovnika.
Sometimes talks about a kingdom.
Isus nekad govori o državi.
Indicating that there is a governmental structure there set by God.
Na taj način on naglašava da postoji određeni sistem rukovanja i rukovođenja gdje je Bog u centru.
The best governmental system we human beings invented is democracy.
Najbolji sistem rukovođenja, najbolji sistem, državni sistem koji smo mi smislili kao ljudska bića je demokratija.
Do you know what democracy is?
Ali da li vi znate šta je demokratija?
When the majority is forcing its will on the minority.
Kada većina prisiljava svoju volju na manjinu.
This is how far we got.
Evo toliko smo mi stigli.
This is the best we could come up with.
To je najbolja ideja koju smo mi mogli smisliti sami.
But God's system of governing the universe.
Ali Božji način rukovođenja u svemiru.
Can be called theocracy.
Može biti nazvan teokratija.
When he is taking in consideration every aspect of living.
Kada on uzima u obzir svaki aspekt života.
And when he makes a decision.
I kada on donosi odluku.
That serves the eternal benefit of all.
Koja služi večnom dobru svih.
Sometimes the Bible uses the expression paradise.
Također se u Bibliji spominje izraz paradajz.
Indicating how beautiful and desirable is his kingdom.
I kroz ovaj izraz ukazuje se na lepotu tog carstva i na taj aspekt koji prosto pleni čovjeka.
But this time Jesus says in my father's house.
Ali ovog puta Isus upotrebljava izraz dom oca moga.
What is my father's house?
Šta je dom oca?
What do you think when next week I'm visiting my parents?
Šta mislite kad sljedeće sedmice ja odem da posjetim svoje roditelje?
How would I come to their house?
Kako ću doći njihovom domu?
I would knock on their door.
Da ću zakucati na vratima.
I would say good evening.
I kazat ću im dobro večer.
My name is Janoš.
Ja se zovem Janoš.
Would you please allow me to come in?
Da biste bili ljubazni da me pustite da uđem.
Would you have a room for me for the night?
Imate li neku sobu da mogu da prenoćim?
Can I take off my shoes please?
Da, mogu da skinem svoje cipele, molim vas.
And maybe would you like to give me a little supper because I'm hungry?
I možda da biste bili ljubazni da mi date neku malu večericu pošto sam dosta gladan.
If I would do this, what do you think
kad
my parents
ja
would look
na taj
like?
Način, šta mislite, kakve bi ja imao roditelje?
They would think that I lost my mind.
Šta bi oni pomislili, pa da sam poludeo?
When I'm coming into my parents' house,
kada dolazim u kuću svojih roditelja,
I am coming home.
Onda dolazim kući.
So what is home for us?
Šta je dom za nas ili kuća?
Home is a place where you can be yourself.
Dom je mjesto gdje možete da budete ono što jeste.
And it doesn't need to be always a physical place.
I ne mora dom biti uvijek jedno fizičko mjesto.
When you are in the presence of people who love you.
Kada ste u prisustvu ljudi koji vas vole.
Who accept you 100%.
Koji vas prihvataju 100%.
Then your real personality comes alive.
Onda će oživjeti vaša prava ličnost.
Then it's the real you.
I onda će se vidjeti ko ste vi u stvari.
But of course, when you go home in the house of your parents,
naravno kad se vratite u kuću svojih roditelja,
or in your home where you live,
ili u vaš dom gdje živite,
you don't need to ask permission to do certain things.
Onda ne trebate zatražiti dozvolu da radite određene stvari.
You feel free.
Osjećate se slobodnim.
You say what is on your heart.
Kažete ono što vam je na srcu.
Home when you are always accepted and loved.
Dom je mjesto gdje ste uvijek prihvaćeni i uvijek ste voljeni.
You are not a guest.
Niste gost.
You are a resident, you live there.
Vi ste stanovnik, vi živite tamo.
And that's home for you.
I to je dom za vas.
It happened with six health workers from Bulgaria.
Dogodilo se sa šest zdravstvenih radnika u Bugarskoj.
They worked in Libya.
Radili su u Libiji.
And they were accused that they contaminated 438 children with HIV virus.
I optuženi su da su zarazili 438 djece sa HIV virusom.
The accusations could not be proved.
Optužbe nisu mogle da se dokažu.
And despite of that fact, they were condemned to death.
A i pored toga bili su osuđeni na smrt.
The date of their execution was postponed a couple of times.
Datum izvršavanja presude je stalno odlagan.
International delegations came in and negotiated for their lives.
Internacionalna delegacija je došla na licu mjesta i pregovarala je kad je reč o njihovom životu.
And the Libyan government decided,
i libijska vlast je odlučila,
that they would change their sentence from execution into life imprisonment.
Da promeni odluku i umjesto smrtne kazne dobiju samo zatvorsku kaznu do kraja života, doživotno.
Just after Nicolas Sarkozy, the French president, was elected,
i nakon izbora Nicolas Sarkozy-a za predsjednika Francuske,
he decided to join this delegation and do something about these
francuski
people.
Francuski predsjednik je odlučio da se priključi delegaciji koja je pregovarala i da učini nešto sa svoje strane.
He managed to convince the Libyans,
uspio je da ubedi Libijce,
that they should not carry the expenses of keeping these six people in prison.
Da nema potrebe da oni snose ogromne troškove vezano za ove ljude po pitanju zatvorske kazne,
but send them home to Bulgaria and let them have their sentence to death in their home country.
Nego bi bilo najbolje da se ovi ljudi pošalju kući u svoju matičnu državu u Bugarsku i tamo mogu doživotno robovati.
I watched on the TV.
Gledao sam na TV-u.
How the Air France aircraft landed at the Sofian airport.
Kako je avion Air France-a došao, kako se spustio avion na aerodrom u Sofiji.
The doors of the aircraft opened.
Vrata aviona su se otvorila.
And six trembling people came out of that plane.
I šest preplašenih, drhćućih ljudi išlo sa aviona.
They were escorted by the police into a separate room at the airport building.
Policija ih je otpratila u jednu posebnu prostoriju na aerodromu.
And you imagine their thoughts, you know, they were looking forward to another prison.
I možete zamisliti šta su imali u mislima, u kakav će to zatvor da istave.
And it just didn't feel right.
I nisu se baš osjećali pravo.
And they were asked to wait in that room.
I u toj sobi, u toj prostoriji gdje su se našli, rečeno im je da trebaju da sačekaju malo.
After a couple of minutes,
nakon
another door
minuta,
opened.
Druga vrata su se otvorila.
And the president of the country of Bulgaria stepped in.
Predsjednik države Bugarske ušao je u prostoriju.
He smiled.
Smešio se.
He opened his arms.
Raširio je svoje ruke.
And he said,
i kazao je,
welcome home.
Dobrodošli kući.
As the president of your country.
Kao predsjednik vaše države.
I am granting you mercy.
Dajem vam pomilovanje.
You are free to go home.
Slobodni ste, idite kući.
And the Libyans?
A Libijci?
They were angry.
Bili su besni.
They said, no.
Rekli su, ne dolazi u obzir.
You haven't released them that you would let them go home.
Kako možete da ih pustite da prosto odu kući?
Why did you set them free?
Šta, zašto ste ih oslobodili?
You should have punished them.
Trebali ste da ih kaznite.
You know what?
Znate šta?
When Jesus comes back,
kada će se Isus vratiti,
and he takes his bride home, people who believed in him,
kada povede svoju nevestu kući, to jest ljude koji su vjerovali u njega,
Satan is going to be angry.
Satana će biti besan.
Said what?
Kazat će, šta?
These people are sinners.
Ovi ljudi su grešnici.
They deserve death.
Oni zaslužuju smrt.
And you give them life,
ti njima daješ život i to večni život.
And God would say,
i Bog će kazati,
hey,
hey,
I am the God of universe.
Ja sam Bog svemira.
And these are my children.
A ovo su moja deca.
And if I am granting them grace forever,
i ako im dajem blagodat za večnost,
and I'm inviting them to come into my family,
ako im pozivam da se priključe mojoj porodici,
when they come home,
kad se vrate kući,
they are free to be the persons I created them to be.
Na za koje sam ih stvorio da budu.
That is what God has in mind.
Upravo to ima Bog na umu.
He would like to release you and me to be the creature he had in mind at the beginning.
On želi da nas oslobodi da bude bića kakvih nas je želeo od samog početka.
Imagine these six people.
Zamislite ovu grupu od šest ljudi.
As they just came out of the airport.
Kako su izašli sa aerodroma.
The president prepared some flowers for them.
Predsjednik je pripremio neko cveće za njih.
Now you are free to go.
I rekao je, sad ste slobodni, idite kući.
What a joy.
Kakva radost.
Now Jesus talks about wedding customs as well.
A sada Isus govori također o nekim običajima vezanim za svadbu.
When a son in Israel in Jesus' times,
kad bi jedan sin ili mladić u Izraelu u Hristovo vrijeme,
grew up and found his bride,
odrastao i našao bi svoju pravu,
he went to his father and said,
onda bi otišao do svog oca i kazao bi,
father, I want to get married.
Oče, želim da se oženim.
And the father said to him,
a otac bi mu kazao,
look at our property.
Pogledaj naše imanje.
It's not big enough.
Nije ovo dovoljno veliko.
You can't take your bride here.
Ne možeš svoju mladu dovesti ovdje.
Our house is too small.
Kuća je suviše tesna.
Let's build an extension to our house.
Hajde da proširimo naš dom.
And then you can bring home your bride when we are ready.
I kad sve bude spremno, onda možeš da dovedeš svoju mladu kući.
And the son said,
i sin bi kazao,
father, can we start today?
Oče, jel možemo danas da počnemo?
And he worked very hard.
I radio je veoma marljivo.
When the extension part was ready,
i kada taj deo koji je proširen, deo novo izgrađen,
the father looked at
his son
and said,
onda otac bi pogledao svog sina i kazao
now
bi,
my son,
sada sine moj,
take your bride home.
Dovedi svoju mladu kući.
Jesus is using this wonderful picture.
Isus koriste ovu predivnu sliku.
Saying, I went into my father's house.
Govoreći, otišao sam u dom mog oca.
And I am preparing a place for you.
I spremam vam mesto.
In the father's house there is place for everybody.
U domu našeg oca ima mjesta za svakoga.
Trust in the promises of Jesus.
Vjerujmo u Hristova obećanja.
Jesus says, you know the way where I'm going.
Isus kaže, znate put, znate kuda idem.
And Thomas said, no, we are not very sure what way are you taking and what direction
kaže,
are you going.
Nisam baš siguran gdje to ideš i koji je put.
Lord, we don't know.
Gospode, mi ne znamo.
Let us know about this way.
Pomozi nam da saznamo vezano za ovaj put nešto.
And that is the question to us as well.
I upravo to je pitanje koje se nama postavlja.
Do we know the way to God's kingdom?
Da li znamo put koji vodi ka Božjem carstvu?
Do we know our destination?
Da li znamo svoje odredište?
Many people are already walking on the way.
Neki ljudi su već na tom putu, idu
many,
tim putem.
Many of us have met the way already.
Mnogi od nas smo možda već našli taj put.
It is not a road of asphalt.
Nije to put koji je izbetoniran.
No.
Nije to betoniran put.
Jesus identifies this way.
Ne, Isus identifikuje ovaj put na sljedeći način.
Jesus says, I am the way.
Isus kaže, ja sam put.
And the truth and the life.
I istina i život.
No one comes to the Father except through me.
Niko neće doći k Ocu do kroz me.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Dame i gospodo.
It doesn't matter whether you are male or female.
Nije bitno da ste muško ili žensko.
Whether you are old or young.
Da ste mladi ili ste stari.
Whether you are a parent or a child.
Da ste roditelj ili ste dete.
Whether you are healthy or you are facing some difficulties of health.
Da ste zdravi ili se suočavate sa određenim zdravstvenim teškoćama.
We all have a possibility to go to the Father through Jesus Christ.
Mi svi imamo mogućnost da odemo Ocu kroz Isusa Hrista.
There is place in God's house.
Mesto u Božjem domu za nas.
It happened during the war in Vietnam.
Dogodilo se ovo za vrijeme Vijetnamskog rata.
An American soldier went home and got to the East Coast and called his parents.
Jedan vojnik Amerikanac došao je, sleteo je u Americi i bio je na istočnoj obali i nazvao je telefonom svoje roditelje.
And said, "Mom, I'm coming home.
Mama, dolazim kući.
Wonderful, son, wonderful, come.
Fantastično, sine, odlično, dođi ti samo.
This is the best time because this is party time.
I rekao je, ovo je najbolje vrijeme jer se proslave organizuju na sve strane.
Hurry up, son, we are just about to leave the house.
Brzo, dođi, žuri, sad baš treba da krenemo.
And he said, "Mommy, I need to ask you a question."
A on je kazao, mama, molim te, trebam da postavim jedno pitanje.
I have a friend with me.
Imam jednog prijatelja sa sobom.
Can he come too?
Da li on može da pođe sa mnom?
Of course, your friend is our friend.
Pa tvoj prijatelj je naš prijatelj.
Take him with you.
Povedi ga sa sobom.
And the man said, "Mom, you don't understand."
A čovjek je kazao, mama, ne razumeš.
This man has his face disfigured.
Ovaj čovjek ima lice koje nije kako treba.
One of his arm is missing.
Nedostaje mu jedna ruka.
And both of his legs.
I izgubio je obe noge.
Can he still come?
Da li i pored toga može da pođe?
Okay, he would not look very nice at our table, but bring him.
Dobro, neće baš izgledati jako lepo za našim stolom, ali povedi ga.
He can stay a couple of days and then he moves on.
Može da ostane nekoliko dana, a onda naći će on već gdje da ide.
The soldier said.
A vojnik je rekao.
Mom, you don't understand.
Mama, ne razumeš me.
This man doesn't have another home.
Ovaj čovjek nema drugi dom.
He would stay with us forever.
Ovaj čovjek će ostati s nama za večnost.
And the mom said.
A mama je kazala,
no.
Ne dolazi uopće.
You know, our country has a very sophisticated social system.
Naša država ima vrlo progresivni socijalni sistem.
One of their institutions are going to take care of.
Neka institucija socijalna će se pobrinuti za taj slučaj.
But son, hurry up and you come.
Ali sine, ti požuri i dođi.
Leave the other guy there.
Ostavi ovog čovjeka tamo.
We don't need him.
Ne treba nam on.
But we need to leave now, the mom said.
Ali sada moramo da odemo, rekla je majka.
They left for a party.
Otišli su na jednu proslavu.
Came back after 3 o'clock in the morning.
Došli su kući u 3 sata posle ponoći.
And the telephone rang.
Zvonio je telefon.
The mother picked the telephone again.
Majka je podigla slušalicu.
The police called.
Policija je zvala.
And the officer said that they have found a body in one of the motels next to the East Coast.
Službenik je kazao da su našli jedno telo u jednoj motelskoj sobi tu na istočnoj obali Amerike.
A person who committed suicide.
A osoba koja je izvršila samoubistvo.
His face is disfigured.
Njegovo lice je ranjeno.
Missing one arm.
Nema jednu ruku.
And both legs.
I nema ni jednu nogu.
And the officer said.
A službenik je kazao.
According to the documents we have at our disposal.
Na osnovu ličnih dokumenata koje nam stoje na raspolaganju.
We believe that this was your son.
Mi smatram da je ovo upravo vaš sin.
Only because the message was there is no place for you. You are not going to look good at the table.
I to se dogodilo samo zbog poruke da nema mjesta za tebe. Nećeš izgledati lepo za našim stolom.
This would never happen with God.
Ovo se nikad ne bi dogodilo
God
sa Bogom.
Says, no matter how you look like.
Bog kaže, bez obzira kako izgledate.
No matter how you feel at the moment.
Bez obzira kako se osjećate u ovom momentu.
You are welcome to come.
Vi ste dobrodošli da dođete.
According to the promise of Jesus.
Na osnovu Isusovog obećanja.
He is going to come.
On će doći.
And the question is, are you waiting? Are you looking forward to this?
Pitanje jeste, da li čekate, da li iščekujete taj moment?
How can we be ready to meet him?
Kako možemo biti spremni na susret sa njim?
If you have ever traveled with small children,
ako ste ikada putovali sa malom decom,
we've done with my two kids when they were small.
To sam mnogo puta iskusio sa svoje dvoje dece kad su bili mali.
You pack everything in the car.
Spakujete sve u auto.
You start the engine.
Pokrenete motor.
And then there is one question immediately.
I onda odmah se postavlja jedno pitanje.
Daddy?
Tata?
Are we there yet?
Da li smo već stigli?
I said, we haven't even started.
Pa kaže, nismo ni pošli na put još.
And over the journey,
i usput,
the smaller your kid is,
što je manje dete,
the more times is going to ask, are we yet there?
To će češće da postavi pitanje, da li smo već stigli?
Adults are behaving very interestingly in waiting rooms.
Odrasli ljudi se ponašaju vrlo interesantno u čekaonicama.
Some are very nervous and checking their watch.
Neki su jako nervozni, non-stop gledaju na svoj sat.
Some others are nervous because they are waiting for somebody.
A neki su nervozni zato što čekaju nekoga.
Imagine this.
Zamislite samo sljedeće.
You're waiting for a bus or a train.
Čekate na voz ili na autobus.
And some people wish that the train or the bus would be punctual.
I neki bi poželili da voz i autobus budu tačni.
By second.
I to na sekundu.
But others,
ali neki drugi,
who know that someone from the family is late.
Koji znaju da neko iz njihove porodice kasni.
They are able even to pray to God. They even want to pray to God.
Oni čak žele da se mole Bogu.
That God would slow the train or the bus
da Bog
down.
Da uspori i voz i autobus.
To be late.
Kako bi kasnio.
So that their family member could catch that
samo
bagel.
Da bi član njegove porodice mogao da uđe u voz ili autobus.
Many people think that, you know, we are on this earth and Jesus didn't come yet.
I mnogi ljudi smatraju da eto mi još uvijek živimo na ovoj zemlji i Isus još uvijek nije došao.
Like him being delayed.
I smatraju da je on vjerovatno kasni.
That's not the truth.
Međutim, to je pogrešno.
God is not hurried and he's
Bog
not delayed.
Niti žuri, niti kasni.
Let's read 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 9.
Čitajmo iz 2. Petrove 3. glave 9. stih. Ne docni Gospod sa obećanjem kao što neki misle da docni, nego nas trpi jer neće da ko pogine, nego svi da dođu u pokajanje.
Let me share with you a couple of waiting thoughts.
Dozvolite mi da podijelim sa vam nekoliko misli vezano za iščekivanje.
What are you spending your time and your money on?
Kako trošimo svoje vrijeme i svoj novac?
That is important in the waiting time.
Ovo je bitno pitanje u vrijeme iščekivanja.
Are these eternal investments?
Da li su ove stvari ulaganje za večnost?
C.S. Lewis says, all that is not eternal is eternally useless.
Lewis kaže, sve što nije večno, beskorisno je za večnost.
Especially young people, please have eternal investment.
Posebno vi mladi, potrudite se da imate ulaganja u vašu večnost.
Please listen to the advice of Apostle Paul.
Slušajte šta kaže apostol Pavle u svom savjetu.
Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things.
Mislite na ono što je gore, a nešto je na zemlji.
Focus on God's kingdom.
Usredsredite se na Božje carstvo.
When we are waiting in the crisis, we need to wait with confidence.
Kada čekamo u krizi, trebamo to činiti sa povjerenjem.
We go through all sorts of hard times.
Prolazimo kroz svakojake teškoće.
But let's see how these hard times are strengthening our hope.
Ali pokušajmo da vidimo na koji način te teškoće ojačavaju našu nadu.
Apostle Paul in Romans chapter 5, he expresses this.
Apostol Pavle u Rimljanima 5. glavi kaže sljedeće. Ne samo pak to, nego se hvalimo i nevoljama, znajući da nevolja trpljenje gradi, a trpljenje iskustvo, a iskustvo nadanje.
We usually don't pray that God would break our leg.
Obično se ne molimo Bogu da nam slomi nogu.
We are not praying for difficulties in our lives.
Ne molimo se za teškoće u svom životu.
But when difficulties are coming,
i ako dođu u teškoće,
they are actually preparing us for eternal life.
Onda u stvari kroz te teškoće se mi pripremamo kroz večnost.
We need patience.
Potrebno je strpljenje.
And you know, in those times, you could learn that from the farmers.
I u to vrijeme strpljenje se učilo od poljoprivrednika, zemljoradnika.
The Bible calls it the plowman.
Biblija naziva, koristi jedan izraz, čovjek koji ore zemljoradnike u našem
My grandfather prevodu. Taught me how to plow the earth.
Moj deda me učio kako se ore zemlja.
And I need to tell you it was such a huge experience.
I mogu da vam kažem to je bilo jako veliko iskustvo za mene.
To keep the plow straight.
Da držite pravo je li tako kad orete.
And know my direction.
I da se držite određenog pravca.
And then receiving certain instructions from my grandfather.
I moj deda mi je dao neka uputstva kako se drži pluk.
But look how the Bible expresses this.
I pogledajte šta Biblija kaže po ovom pitanju.
In James 5, 7 and 8.
Jakovljeva, peta glava. Trpite dakle, braćo moje, da do dolaska gospodnjega, gle težak čeka plemeniti rod iz zemlje i rado trpi dok ne primi dažd, rani i pozni. Trpite dakle i vi, i utvrdite srca svoja jer se dolazak gospodnji približi.
When we do our duties,
kada činimo svoje dužnosti
and we believe that God is active and he is doing his,
i da kada vjerujemo da je Bog aktivan i da on radi svoj dio posla,
then we work very well together with God.
Onda vrlo dobro sarađujemo, odlično sarađujemo sa Bogom.
Now, how is this affecting our relationships?
Na koji način to utiče naše odnose?
Let's read on from the book of James.
Nastavimo da čitamo tekst iz Jakovljeve poslanice. Ne uzdišite jedan na drugoga, braćo, da ne budete osuđeni. Gle, sudija stoji pred vratima. Uzmite, braćo moje, za ugled stradanja proroka koji govoriše u ime Gospoda. Gle, blažene nazivamo one koji pretrpeše. Trpljenje Jovljevo čuste i pošlje da gospodnji videste, jer je gospod milostiv i smiluje se.
Imagine this.
Zamislimo samo sljedeće.
In the waiting room there is no time to compare ourselves with each other.
U čekonici nema vremena za upoređivanje sa drugom osobom.
But there is time to encourage each other.
Međutim postoji vrijeme da ohrabrujemo jedni druge.
And when we see from the word of God how many people suffered and they lived through those sufferings.
I kada iz Biblije kad vidimo koliko je broj ljudi koji su stradali u životu i kako su uspješno prošli kroz svoje probe.
That encourages us.
Onda njihov primjer nas ohrabruje.
And that opens our eyes.
I to nam otvara oči.
So we acknowledge that the Lord is full of compassion and mercy.
Kako bi mogli da priznamo, da doživimo šta to znači da je Bog pun saosećanja i milosti.
So why is then the apparent delay of Jesus Christ?
Zašto onda postoji prividno kašnjenje u povratku Isusa Hrista?
Laszlo has a wonderful scientific paper on that.
Laszlo je napisao jedan predivan naučni rad na
And
tu
I
temu.
Hope that it is going to be translated into Serbian so you can all read it.
I nadam se da će taj naučni rad biti preveden na srpski kako bi svi mogli da to pročitate.
Jesus is not delaying.
Jer Isus ne kasni.
He did not give up on the salvation of people.
On se nije odrekao spasenja ljudi.
Of course many people are tired and sick when they see all the suffering on this earth.
Naravno mnogi ljudi su se već premorili kad vide svu patnju na ovom svijetu.
And they are praying to God saying please Lord come quickly.
I oni se mole Bogu i kažu Gospode dođi što pre.
But what is the plowman doing?
Ali šta radi zemljoradnik koji ore?
He is working
on
diligently
radi, i to vredno
and he is waiting.
I čeka.
This is very important to see how we work together with God.
I ovo je jako bitno kako bi razumeli koje su osnovni principi u saradnji sa Bogom.
We acknowledge our dependence on God.
Jer od suštinskog je značaja da budemo svjesni i priznamo svoju zavisnost od Boga.
So after the plowman has cultivated the land.
Dakle, nakon što je zemljoradnik obradio zemlju,
has sown the seed.
Posejao je seme.
There is nothing to do. After that.
Ništa više u suštini ne može uraditi.
You wait for God.
Nego čekate da Bog deluje.
And God is giving the crops.
I Bog vam daje rod.
And the plowman is not waiting in vain.
I zemljoradnik ne čeka uzaludno.
It happened at one of the big lakes of America.
Ovo se dogodilo pored jednog velikog jezera u Americi.
An old man decided to spend a nice day alone.
Jedan starac odlučuje da provede sam jedan predivan dan.
He went fishing and he wanted quietness.
Želio je da bude u tišini i izašao je da peca.
Couple of hours went excellently well.
prvih nekoliko sati je odlično prošlo.
But suddenly he heard someone coming whistling and singing and whistling and singing.
Ali odjednom čuje nekoga kako prilazi i peva i kako govori.
It was a little boy between 8 and 10.
Bio dečkić koji imao između 8 i 10 godina.
And he comes and he sees this man.
I došao je i prišao je ovom čovjeku.
And he said, "Good day, sir."
I kazao je, "Dobar dan, gospodine."
"What are you doing here?"
"Šta vi radite ovdje?"
"Wonderful to see you."
"Predivno je vidjeti vas."
And the man felt disturbed.
A čovjek je bio uznemiren.
And he looked at the boy.
Pogledao je dečka.
And he said,
I ovako je reagovao.
And the boy said,
a dečko je kazao,
"Okay, let me see how many fish you catch."
Ajde vidimo koliko ste to riba upecali.
"Ah, it's only one."
"Oh, samo jedna."
"Sir, you need to hurry on."
"Oh, gospodine, morate malo da budete aktivniji. Ako želite da imate dobar ručak ili večeru."
And the old man looked at him and said,
čovjek, stari čovjek ga je ugledao i kazao je ovako.
And the boy said, "Can't you speak?"
A dečko je kazao, "Pa zar vi ne znate da govorite?"
And the old man said,
A čovjek je upravo ovako reagovao.
The boy started talking and doing all sorts of things just make this man
I dečko je počeo da priča i izvodio je razne stvari samo kako bi naterao ovog čovjeka da progovori.
And finally the old man spoke.
I na kraju ovaj starac je progovorio.
"What are you doing here?"
Pitao, "Šta ćeš ti ovdje?"
"Oh, sir, I'm so glad you can speak."
"O, gospodine, vidim da vi znate da govorite."
"I came here to wait for the ship."
"Došao sam da čekam na brod."
"But there is no port here."
"Ali to nema luke," kazao je starac.
"The port is 3 kilometers up, and you need to go now."
"Luka je 3 kilometra gore i sada trebaš da kreneš."
"Because the ship is going to start within about an hour."
"Zato što za sat vremena će poći brod."
"You are going to be late."
"I zakasnit ćeš."
"Hey, this is the last ship today."
"Hey, ovo je posljednji voz danas."
And the boy smiled and said,
a dečko se smešio i kazao je, "Gospodine,
I'm waiting for the ship here."
"Ja ću ovdje da čekam na brod."
And the old man said, "What a stubborn boy you
are." "Kazao, kakav si ti to tvrdoglavo dečko."
"I tell you, you need to run."
"Pa rekao sam ti da trebaš da trčiš."
"You're going to be late."
"Zakasnit ćeš."
"Sir."
"Gospodine,
I am waiting for the ship here."
"Ja ću ovdje da čekam na brod."
"Look at him."
"Pogledajte ga."
"You're going to miss that ship."
"Pogledaj ga. Zakasnit ćeš na taj brod."
"And you're going to stay here overnight."
"Ti ćeš čitavu noć provesti ovdje u mraku."
And the boy said,
i dečko je kazao,
"I don't mind."
"Baš me briga."
"But I am waiting for the ship here."
"Ali ja ću ovdje čekati na brod."
And the old man said, "I refuse to talk to you."
Starac kaže, "Odbijam da razgovaram dalje s tobom."
"You are going to learn a big lesson of your life."
"Naučit ćeš ti veliku lekciju svoga života danas. Vidjet ćeš ti to."
Good hour later,
za dobri sat vremena,
they could hear the big steam engine of the ship coming.
Moglo se čuti motor parnog broda, velikog parnog broda.
The old man already got ready, you know, for the lesson of the boy.
Starac se već spremio kako da očita lekciju ovom dečaku.
Now he is going to learn his lesson.
I kazao, sad će on da se nauči pameti.
So the ship was coming and coming and coming closer.
Brod se približavao, približavao i približavao.
And then suddenly they could hear.
I odjednom moglo se čuti.
The engines slowing down.
Da se motor usporava. Da motor usporava.
And just close to them.
I blizu njih.
The ship stopped.
Brod je stao.
They lowered down a boat.
Stavili su jedan čamac.
Two sailmen just jumped into that boat.
Dva mornara su ušla u čamac.
Paddled to the shore.
I dovestali su do obale.
Right to the place where this boy was.
Tačno gdje se nalazi ovaj dečko.
And they just jumped in.
I dali su mu znak da skoči u čamac.
The boy jumped in.
Dečko je skočio.
The old man was.
Starac je bio šokiran.
So surprised, he couldn't say one word.
Toliko je bio iznenađen da nije ni jednu riječ mogao izgovoriti.
They paddled back to the ship.
Dovestali su nazad.
The boy climbed the ladder very quickly.
Do broda. Dečko se brzo popeo kroz merdevine na brod.
Then he ran to the back of the deck.
I onda je otrčao do kraja palube.
And he started shouting to the old man.
I počeo je da viče starcu.
Old man!
Starče!
I forgot to tell you something.
Zaboravio sam nešto ti kažem.
The captain of this ship is my father.
Kapetan ovog broda je moj otac.
He told me to wait here.
On mi je rekao da ga čekam na ovom mestu i pokupit će me.
Have a nice day.
Imajte lep dan.
My friends.
Prijatelji moji.
The captain of the universe.
Kapetan svemira.
Has promised to come back.
Je obećao da će se vratiti na ovu planetu.
And he is looking forward to that day.
I on iščekuje taj dan.
When he is going to receive his bride.
Kada će moći da primi svoju mladu.
You and me.
Vas i mene.
To take us home.
Da nas povede kući.
But we can be the very same person he had in mind when he created
kako
us.
Kako bi mogli da budemo ista osoba koju on imao na umu kad nas je stvorio.
Let us read what Martin Luther said about this.
Čitajmo šta je Martin Luther zapisao o
ovome. We all desire that day.
Sa čežnjom iščekujemo radost toga dana.
If someone is not yet ready to desire this day,
osoba koja nije još spremna da čezne za ovim danom,
and he does not understand the Lord's prayer,
nije naučila još da se moli Oče naš,
and cannot pray it from the heart,
a još manje zna da se moli ovu molitvu iz srca,
Jesus is coming back.
Isus se vraća.
And he would like us to be with him for an eternity.
I on bi želio da budemo sa njim kroz čitavu večnost.
Let's pray for this.
Pomolimo se za ovo.
Father in heaven, we want to thank you for Jesus, your son.
Nebeski Oče, želimo da zahvalimo za Isusa Hrista, tvog sina.
Thank you that you have plenty of room in your kingdom.
Hvala ti što imaš mnogo mesta u svom carstvu.
And we want to thank you that Jesus is the word of God to us.
Želimo da ti se zahvalimo što je Isus riječ Božja za nas.
And we can trust his presence.
I što možemo da imamo povjerenje u njegovu prisustvo.
Even if we cannot see him face by face.
Čak i da ne možemo da ga vidimo licem k licu.
We have his word with us.
Ali pored toga imamo njegovu riječ sa nama.
And his word is as good as his presence.
I njegova riječ je isto toliko dobra kao i njegovo prisustvo.
While we are waiting, we are studying your word, Jesus.
Dok čekamo na tvoj povratak, mi proučavamo tvoju riječ, Isuse.
We believe you.
Mi vjerujemo tebi.
And we want to take you at your word.
I mi želimo da te uzmemo za tvoju riječ.
Come back quickly.
Vrati se brzo.
And take us home.
I povedi nas kući.
We know that you have prepared that home for us.
Mi znamo da si nam ti pripravio dom.
That you want us to enjoy all the benefits of eternal life.
I da želiš da uživamo u svim blagodatima tvog večnog carstva.
Thank you that it doesn't matter how we look.
Hvala ti što nije bitno kako izgledamo.
Whether we are healthy or not.
Da smo zdravi ili nismo.
Whether we are young or old.
Da smo stari ili mladi.
That there is only one way to your kingdom and that is you personally.
Jer postoji jedan jedini put do tvog carstva, to si ti, Gospode.
Thank you that you have promised you come back.
Hvala ti što si nam obećao da će se vratiti.
Like that little boy, we are waiting for you here.
Kao taj mali dečko, mi te čekamo ovdje.
And we are looking forward to the joy of that day.
I mi iščekujemo radost toga dana.
When we see your beautiful face.
Kada ćemo moći da vidimo tvoje predivno lice.
When you are inviting us in.
Kada ćeš pozvati unutra.
And saying, you are welcome, my faithful servant.
I reći ćeš nam dobrodošao, moj vjerni sluga.
Come in and inherit my father's home.
Dođi i nasledi dom mog oca.
Lord, we pray.
Gospode, mi se molimo tebi.
That none of us would miss that
da
day.
Niko od nas ne propusti taj
that
dan.
We would spend eternity together.
Da možemo zajedno sa tobom provesti večnost.
We ask these in Jesus' name.
Sve te ovo molimo u Isusovo ime.
Amen.
Amen.